Land use laws govern the way that property can be used and developed in the city and throughout the state. And in Oregon, we have a statewide system, and then each city and county and jurisdiction has to comply with those laws. Although inside our city, we get to decide, you know, what uses we want to allow and where. So in Oregon in the 70s, there was a fear that people were moving here so fast that Oregon was going to turn into a different type of state, you know, maybe a fear of turning into California. And so the governor at the time, Governor Tom McCall, and other state legislators came together and they adopted Senate Bill 100 and created our state land use system. The main goal was to protect our farm and forest land and then make sure that city type development, you know, urban levels of development, that those happen inside cities and not outside on our farmland and our forest land. The city's been kind of growing with zoning, of course, in place since about the 20s. And every once in a while, we take a step back and say, is this really serving the needs of our community? And we get a chance to look at our zoning, so what kind of development's allowed and where and how, but also things like our needs for parks, our transportation plan, which can include, you know, biking and walking. We always start with what are you proposing, where are you located, what's your zoning, and then we go from there and help people figure out what regulations apply to their development. Land use regulations have some element of safety and then some element of compatibility in the community. So for sure you're going to have setback regulations and height regulations that we apply. We might even get into the design of the building. Well, by the time you're ready to build a home, the property's already probably gone through numerous land use regulations and development, you know, proposals and plans. So generally, land starts, you know, a larger piece of land and somebody subdivides it and they turn into smaller lots for home development. So subdivisions are something that a lot of the community is aware of because a lot of times they're in the paper, they have public hearings. Once you get through that and the lot is created, maybe by a developer or homeowner who subdivided their land, then it's a pretty easy process to build a house as far as the regulations. You just get a building permit, and through that building permit process at the city, every department that, you know, would have a say reviews it all together. In Oregon, in land use planning, the number one statewide planning goal is that people should be involved in land use that happens in their community and decision making. But there are things that are exempt from that. So sometimes you'll see a development happening and say, I live nearby, I didn't get notice. And that's probably because they met all the regulations. And there was no discretion involved in approving it. They just met everything and so they got their permits. But a lot of land use triggers that threshold of we need to involve the public. And so a lot of items before they get approved, they go out for notice. So we send mailed notice to the neighbors, the neighborhood association, and other interested parties, and get their feedback before we would approve it. And then if somebody thinks it didn't meet the regulations, they could appeal it, and then it would have a public hearing.